Hey guys, this is a very quick video, and yeah, this is not about cricket. You can already see the background and sort of figure out what we're going to talk about. I've had a very bad reservation about how Sania married a Pakistani, but then it's okay. It's a personal choice. They've been living in Dubai. But to turn up and support Pakistan and cheer like this, what does it speak about her, her personality as an Indian? That is, and also, you know, make it worse, man. She also represented India. What's your thought on this?
To be honest, I know for someone who has followed sports all my life, to be honest, and loved watching someone wearing an Indian jersey, no matter which stage it is, it's always a matter of pride for us. And I've really grown up watching a lot of these Commonwealths, Olympics, Asiads, and a lot of tennis tournaments, for example. Also, tennis was also my favorite sport to watch because of my mother's influence. And then Sania Mirza was always on the radar that time too, yeah. When she was, you know, before her marriage and everything. So everyone who donned the Indian jersey represented India for me. And then I get it. It's a matter of personal choice of marriage and everything. Everybody has their right to do so. And yeah, we have no issues with that. But then the only reservations that we have, and it's uncomfortable for us to watch for someone who has represented India at such high stages, won Grand Slams, represented India, walked behind the Indian flag in Asiads, Olympics, or the Commonwealth Games, you know, and wore that Indian flag on their chest and played. It really hurts to see, her turn up and support Pakistan at and that stage.
Really, it's because Pakistan, considering the political tension between India and Pakistan, had it been some other country, okay, fine. It's she's cheering up for her husband. But considering how difficult, tricky the political situation between India and Pakistan has always been, the balls on her to do this really, speaks about how she just doesn't care what the country thinks.
Yeah, exactly. I mean, it's hardly anyone in the country knows doesn't know the rivalry that India and Pakistan have. It's not like India is completely imposing something on Pakistanis or something. They have always been the aggressor and we have always been the victims at times. And we have pushed back when they have pushed on us. And then that's the result of 3.5 the wars that we have had with them. Kargil being the semi kind of a war, half kind of a war. And they keep continuing to killing our civilians and also soldiers. Soldiers is fine, but then civilians also. So that also should speak the nature of the mentality of that nation as a whole. And it's disappointing for her to turn up there and
very disappointing, very hurting. And see, I'll just talk about this as well. Mohammad Shami was deemed as a traitor for bowling bad against Pakistan, which is part of the game.
Rectification, most of the accounts from which the tweets or the comments had gone were all turned out to be, fake accounts that have been created from the Pakistani-based.
Pakistani, I talked about
so it that. India, back home, it was not really a lot of hate messages directed at him. It is just because it's someone,
You always get such fanatics. There are always such fanatics. I'm not denying that it didn't happen. But he was just blown out of proportion. He was just blown out of proportion for what he did. It happened. I mean, I really felt sorry for him, for what had happened. But he got so much backlashes for bowling bad, not even purposefully against Pakistan. Then she goes and does this. Why nobody is not talking about it? What is the apprehension behind this?
It symbolizes the liberals' wet dream. It is only when the majority kind of push back onto the scene or some sort of even one comment, it will be termed as the community's hate towards the other community. But then when it's the other way around, they will be like the selected few people of that community have this thing. So it doesn't it doesn't mean that the entire community is responsible for that hate or something. So it's just the twisting and turning of facts. And it is really sorry for top sports person like her, was represented at such top levels.
Yeah.
To, you know,
it hurts even more. Yeah.
Yeah,
I hope
that is
she
really.
figures it out somehow that what she's doing is just not right. And also,
No.
guys, yeah.
If she hasn't figured out by these many years
she
after
doesn't
marriage,
care.
also, it means that they don't really bother about you know, the kind of criticism or
Exactly.
whatever is leveled against her. So.
So yeah, guys, this was a very quick one, and this had nothing to do with cricket, but we still had to make it because we felt it wrong, and we did it because we simply love our country. And as
Yeah.
usual, man,
And
thanks for yeah, go ahead.
yeah, before someone jumps gun and tells, "Oh, you're hyper nationalistic bullshit," and you know,
Tourist.
the choice of small words that people use nowadays so easily, this fascist, Nazi, this thing and all. Before you jump
Tourist,
on
just
our,
tourist.
you just have to make a proper you know, analysis of the situation without hyper. You know, hyperventilating at a situation that then you realize, you know, the magnitude of the, you know, the thing that she has done.
And
That's all I have.
yeah, also you're very much welcome to, you know, comment down below whatever you think is right or wrong. This opinions are always subjective, and again, thanks for joining, man. And also, guys,
Yeah,
thanks for
always.
watching.
It's a pleasure. Pleasure
Thanks,
to
man.
chat.